friends, welcome back to my channel. Today again I'm inside my kitchen and I'm with a very big mission, you know, this coral mission, bamboo shoot. So every time I have seen in other videos and all, people do eat, and so I also got an idea to prepare this and show you all in my video. So I have asked one of my friend, she is a Manipuri friend, she has given me a recipe, very beautiful recipe. And I have also asked my mother-in-law, she told me something like the acility, so acility styled recipe I have also got. And now I'm going to mix two things, Manipuri and Sileti recipe together with this coral, and we call this coral in Sileti. So then I'm going to give it my own twist. So let us find out how it becomes. So I think I'll be able to eat it, and you all will also be able to try it at home. So till then, stay tuned, subscribe my channel, do press the bell icon. Thanks for watching my channel and just stay tuned to the end of this video.
So friends, these bamboo shoots or the bamboo sprouts are edible shoots. So the cover is quite tough and you can't open it with your bare hands, so you need a one knife. So I'm trying to open it, and this is for the first time I'm experiencing how to uncover the shoot. So you have to be a little bit careful with this. And people who are very much acquainted and regularly they do this kind of a job, so they'll be finding me a little bit messy. But slowly, with the passing of time, I'm trying to discover things and exploring this whole thing. So now finally I'm done with one shoot, so I'll be doing with the others. Friends, you'll be amazed to hear that the bamboo shoot raw, they have huge nutritional value. So they have energy, carbohydrate, sugar, dietary fiber, fat, protein, vitamins, minerals. Oh my god, so many things. Friends, now I have peeled the cover. So now I have, after washing it, then I'm cutting it, and I'll be chopping it into small pieces. And it is up to you what kind of piece you want to chop them into. So it is up to you and as per your conveniences and your requirement. So the amount that I'm taking it, because I'll be sharing a little bit with my friend. So after chopping, it looks like this. And now after this, I'll be putting this into the pressure cooker. So we have to pressure cook, or you can just boil it in a saucepan, a little bit of salt. But now I'll be putting this in the pressure cooker with a little bit of water and salt, and I'll be draining out the water. And then after that, we'll start cooking this bamboo shoot. And there are various kind of ways where you can cook. You can cook it with in a vegetarian way, or you can also cook in a non-vegetarian way also. So today I'll be going to show you a little bit of non-vegetarian way of, and you can also make it in a vegetarian way, whatever way you like to, but it will taste awesome. Now I'm putting the pressure cooker on the flame, and I'll be waiting for some time. And here the ingredients, we'll be using onion, garlic, tomato, and a little bit of green chilies according to your taste. So these are the basic ingredients which I would require to make, and I'll be making them into a paste, for which I'll have to go to the grinding machine here. So in the mixer jar, so I'm putting this all, and I'll be pasting them all together. So you can also fry the onions, and then also you can do it in a different way, whatever way you like. But my way of doing it's like that, when I go to work and all, it's like I stay in a hurry and I have to chop them all together and just finish my work all together, and my cooking also. So this is how I do it, very fast. And it doesn't matter, the taste doesn't differ actually, so it's fine, you know. So friends, I am not a medical professional, but still, from the study of Wikipedia about the bamboo shoots, I have found that the raw bamboo shoots contain kinogenic glycosides and these are natural toxins. What I have understood is that the glycosides are also classified according to the chemical nature of the algae cone. Going into too much detail, I would like to tell this actually dilates the coronary arteries as well as the blocked calcium channels. So isn't it interesting? So now I have finished boiling and now I'm taking it out from the pressure cooker and I will drain the extra water which is present there. And now in this pan I'll be putting a little bit of oil. It is according to your necessity and there is no hard and fast rule. So here goes the paste. The ginger, garlic, tomato and onion and the chili paste all together. So there's tomato also. This tomato will give a little bit of very sweet and tangy taste. Here a little bit of haldi and chili powder and dhania powder. So I'm not giving too much of masalas because I don't want the raw taste or the actual natural taste to go away or the masalas to take over the taste of the natural shoots. So here is the interesting part. Here I have given the fermented fish, small, which we call shidol. People who don't actually eat a shidol, they can skip this and they can add the bamboo shoot here, which I am doing now. I'm adding this to the whole masala thing and then I'll be stirring it for a few minutes and then cover it up. Friends, in Nepal they are used in dishes which have been well known in Nepal for centuries. This proves that yesterday when I was talking to the person, he was a Nepali person and he told me correctly that they also have, and Manipuri people, they do have this dish, and maybe with shidol or without the fermented fish. And the popular dish is tama, which is a fermented bamboo shoot with potato and beans. In Assamese, bamboo shoots are part of traditional Assamese cuisine and they are called the khorisa and bahagas in Assamese. In Manipur, they are called at usoi. They are also fermented and preserved, after which they are known as soibam.
So friends, now we are at the final phase. So I'm going to take it out and I think it's almost done. So let me see. So I'll take this to my friend now and she will taste it and she will tell me whether it's authentic or not. So you can see, my dear friends, it just looks like that and I hope it would taste nice. So a new dish from my side. So I hope you have liked the video. So stay tuned with me for my next video, such interesting videos. So till then, subscribe, press the bell icon. Okay, till then, ta-ta and bye-bye. See you next time. So friends, just wait. I just went to my friend's house and I gave her to taste a little bit. So she says it's mouth-watering and she's longing for more. So I'm proud that I could make it successful and I hope she'll also post there in my comment section. So you also make it, try it at home. You can make it in different ways. So till then, now finally tata and bye-bye. So wait for my next video. Bye.